My life learning starts in the 60s when I was 8 or 9 years old. I was born in a rich family with a legendary father. He was involved in the freedom struggle of India very thickly. But by the time I was a child and I required his attention, I was lucky to have him by my side, hand-holding me. Being the youngest of 7 children, I have 4 brothers and 2 sisters, and only one of them are alive now. I'm the youngest. He was quite old. My father was quite old by the time I was born and used to spend more time at home. During the long hours that we spent together, he used to be playful with me, and I was told that he was a very strict person, but he used to be very playful. And because I was like a grandchild to him, I have some of my nephews who are older than me, because my mother and my sisters believed in delivering together, or even my sisters delivered earlier than my mother delivered me. So I have 2 of my nephews who are nephew and nieces who are elder than me. Anyway, so he used to spend a lot of time with me. So asking mental maths questions, doing a lot of things, I used to read to him the newspaper from beginning to the end. The Matrubhumi newspaper, which used to come at that time, I used to read that towards the end, right before I left for my I'll explain that. He also started getting the English newspaper. And so I had this task of reading to him everything. So I was very well versed with what is happening all over the world, because I had to read to him this either in the morning or after the class in the evening. So the mental maths was a very tough situation, where from the usual things, you know, he used to go to things like what is 18 into 22, or things like that. And I'm sure that many of us won't be able to do it without a calculator now. He also used to make me write his business accounts. And I was exposed to single entry accounting and ledgers, and give an insight into how business is carried out, while I was studying in the 7th standard. This gave me an ability to look into the numbers in business later, which helped me a lot. Because with all the chartered accountants around me, we have some 40 or 50 of them in different institutions, and many of them work closely with me, like Wilson and many others. So this really helped me to get a clue on numbers. Now, sitting beside him, I told you that he was quite legendary, because he used to be the local judge at that time in the 1950s. You should remember, he used to be the local judge, and people used to come to him to solve disputes and to mediate and all. So he used to give his verdict, and people used to accept that. And he was also very, very quickly involved in the infrastructure creation of the village, the school, the hospital. And he brought electricity into the village, telephone, and all this he did. And I was seeing it. Most importantly, it was the way in which he was helping people. He used to give away part of what he possessed to the underprivileged. And that is something which has stuck to me and which has remained with me. So all this happened, I sitting beside him, from the age of, I remember, some 4 or 5 years up to the age of 12, when I had to leave to Calicut for further education. So what is that lesson that I have learned out of it? Spend quality time with your children. That is a life lesson. Greatest investment you can make in your life is to spend time with your children. That is much more than even the education, formal education that you, of course, you will be giving that, the money you give, whatever you give, I think the first lesson I learned was the benefit I got by sitting the side of my father and seeing him doing, walking the talk, not just advising and doing something else. I could see it firsthand. And that is one of the greatest gifts that he has given me.